You know, there are very practical things with space and time. I'm going out on tour. I remember in 1979 with a piece I did with Lucinda Childs called Dance. Every stage was a different size. If the hall is larger, they have to dance quicker and the music has to be played faster. If the hall is smaller, you slow the music down. This is not theory. I'm talking about the practical matters of moving around the stage. I've written 26 operas, I've done 40 films, 30 ballets, that's what I do. I play the piano, that's technique. My son uses a computer, that's technique. These are extensions of the human brain. It's through these extensions that we can handle things, that we can understand our history, that we can talk about the future, and that we can even talk about the past. But we also have to learn what the new languages are. The new languages are going to help us to live in a different kind of a world. The thing that's not so positive is, what do we do all with the waste material? What do we do with the jobs that are lost? It forces us to change and think about how we live. Nothing can be more special to a culture than the art, the painting, the poetry, the things that express the spirit, the human spirit. We make comments about our own society, and we talk about the way people live together, how we use the materials of life, how we either save the environment or we destroy the environment, how we deal with our education. All these are the most interesting things. These are the proper subjects of dialogue and the proper things of investigation. These things will affect how we actually live. There's another question is, what can our culture do? Can we leave something for future people? And in fact, we do that all the time. The pyramids of Mexico, the pyramids of Egypt, the architecture of any ancient place, it tells us tremendous amounts about what life was like. A very interesting topic is, when you talk about the life of the city, you learn about many other things. Things that might be not the first thing you would think about, but the practical things that happened in that life. It's very interesting to speculate about music in that way. The idea that music was something modern or even ancient, within our idea of an ancient, is nowhere near correct. It seems that there might have been music 70,000 years ago. What do we have left? We have bird wings. We have little pieces of evidence. It doesn't tell us much, but in a way it does. It tells us that someone is playing, probably some people are listening, so that the elements of society are already taking place. And so we have to backdate now. When does modern things that we think in terms of modern life, when does that begin? And that's continuously, if you look into this kind of history, those dates are going further and further and further back. The secret of being radical is being independent. That's the hardest thing. That means maybe you don't take an easy job to get. Maybe you don't take a teaching job, or you don't take some way that you find a different way. You find a different way of working. The more you connect yourself to systems that already exist, the less chance you have to do something new. I mean, that's my feeling. I have a predilection. That means I have a liking and a desire to do things like that. Some people don't do it. I know people that they can't do that, and they can do beautiful work, they can do wonderful work, but it may not be on the barriers of the future. The best time for learning is when you don't know what's happening. If you know what's happening, there's nothing to learn.